Well, friends, to give you a small start, I have already put a timer. I know I talk a lot, but there are few things maybe you all do not know about me personally. Well, I can just start with the beginning. I can tell you when I was in 10th standard, okay, that's just hardly 14, 15 years, one incident happened where the school buses used to always bring us and take us back to school and home. But one incident where I participated in a cultural event in the school and the teacher said, let's go post school to my house, practice, and then you can go back home. And it was for, I think, either Republic Day or Independence Day. It was a song we had to sing. And that day it became so late, 8 o'clock. Usually I'm home by 6, 8 o'clock. And I had never ventured out alone on my own. Somebody dropped me halfway. And from there, I was so scared. I was so naive, I can say. And I was full shaky, sweating and looking around me, because you always believe as a young girl, you never know who's following you. You never know who's looking at you. You never know who has eyes on you. And that walk of half an hour to my home. And when I reached home, it was even more tragic. My parents were so furious. Where have you disappeared? Those times, it wasn't so convenient, not easy to call. Mobiles, so out of question. Landlines were also rare. And that one incident, I can never forget. But from those who know me today, y'all know, y'all can't even imagine that I was like that. Well, like our other friend, I also got married pretty early. I started working. I got my job even before I gave the last paper of my graduation, because that is what my father believed. I did come from a Brahmin conservative family where even jeans I have never worn in my life before I got married, because my father said, you do not wear jeans in our house. And there was so much of restrictions. He believed I should take up a first job the day I finished my graduation. Yes, fifth day after my graduation, I already had got a job. I started with sales, marketing and customer service. But I believe, being a science graduate, it was important I stick to my field of science. Lot of up and down, troughs and crests in my journey in life. But I have just a few things to tell you today, a few takeaways. Selflessness is in our genome. Okay, woman means it's somewhere inside, deep inscribed in us, whether we are taught it at home or not taught, we are selfless, because we are the strength, we are the power behind every family. Whether it is our own, whether it is our maternal family, in-laws family, whatever it is, we are there as strong pillars. And as we grow, we should take that opportunity where we can learn, try to implement whatever we learn. And yes, most important, what I feel very proud of today is you slowly, gradually, with your culture, you teach, you pass it on to your next generation. Whether it is a son or a daughter doesn't matter today. But today, when I look back, even in my in-laws family, I'm the eldest of the daughters-in-law, and we are two more. There are five women, next generation in our family, but including my mother-in-law, including my sisters-in-law, they all believe, Usha, they are your embodiment. They are as empowered as you are. So it is very, very important that we learn whatever comes in our way. I started my career with sales, marketing, customer service, then went on to diagnostics, then came back to even working for a BPO in difficult times. Then went back to hospital administration, did a PhD. I still have my background in diagnostics. And today I am so proud to be associated a little after the inception of Velocity. But yes, over 3 years with Velocity, everywhere I had opportunities to implement what I had learned, plus learn new. That's how, because I took whatever came in my stride every single day, it was easier to just become multifaceted and multitasking. That is precisely what each woman have it in their core. They can multitask, but never forget, in your selflessness, never forget yourselves. Somebody taught me, who was a senior in another network marketing company, Usha, first you pamper yourself. if you pamper yourself, you will be happy within and you will be able to give that out to anybody and everybody around you. Then yes, the selflessness never falls short. So learn to be happy yourselves by pampering yourselves. Hema, Latha, the kid seems to be very happy. I'm so excited. And yes, this journey has taken me through NGOs, through women empowerment programs. I have worked for trust funds like Tata Trust, HDFC Foundation. I have even been associated with UNDP for their skilling programs. And I'm very proud to say it was a dream that I wanted to speak at the United Nations. Pamela started by mentioning about the United Nations. In the next 5 to 7 days, there is the Consultative Status of Women conference happening at the United Nations, where I had submitted a statement on behalf of the NGO and it has got accepted. It is on the UNCSW website today. And the 5 giveaways is, don't forget your rights as a woman, educational attainment, skilling, wherever possible, not just yourself. When you are empowered, pick up at least one woman in your life, not just your family. Pick up maybe your maid's daughter, pick up maybe some taxi driver's daughter or a son. Pick them up, empower them, give them the opportunity for skilling. If you want, you sponsor them because you can afford it. It will only give you blessings and goodwill in life and you will never fall short of anything. Money is not everything. Lockdown has been difficult for so many of us, but money, take it from me, it's not everything. Once you're able to give them the right education, attainment, skilling, you will give them an opportunity to economic independence. That will then translate into economic participation. They will be able to stand firm in their own houses and that will then take care of the entire household and the society, health and well-being, and also lead to political participation and empowerment. Yes, women must come forward even in the political participation because that is where thinking more logically, we are able to implement something for a bigger, better good. I will stop here. I've overshot my time, but thank you so much for the opportunity and I love you all. A very happy Women's Day to all of you once again. Thank you, Pamela. Thank you, Stan, sir.